The evolution of U.S. strategic bombers tells a story of power, innovation, and dominance in the skies. From the early days of long-range warfare to the stealth era, each generation pushed the limits of range, speed, and precision. These bombers became symbols of deterrence and global reach, shaping decades of military strategy. The first one is the Boeing B-29 Superfortress. This bomber was conceived as the first true strategic bomber. It was developed during World War II to fulfill America's urgent need for a long-range, high-altitude bomber capable of reaching Japan's heartland. Introduced on May 8, 1944, it marked a major leap beyond earlier bombers like the B-17, which lacked both the range and payload for deep strategic missions. Powered by four Wright R-3350 radial engines, it could reach speeds of 357 miles per hour and fly over 3,250 miles while carrying up to 20,000 pounds of bombs. The B-29 proved its effectiveness in devastating campaigns over Japan. It was also the aircraft chosen to deliver the atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, altering the course of history. Over 3,900 units were built, making it the largest bomber production run of the war. It marked the transition from piston-driven bombers to more advanced long-range strategic aircraft. The second U.S. strategic bomber is the Convair B-36 Peacemaker. The Convair B-36 Peacemaker emerged in the early Cold War, which was introduced in 1948. Designed to strike the Soviet Union without relying on overseas bases, it symbolized long-range strategic power. Powered by six piston engines and later four jet engines, it combined range and unprecedented payload capacity. With a 230-foot wingspan and nearly 4,000 miles of combat range, it could carry up to 86,000 pounds of bombs, the largest load of its era. Though its top speed of 435 miles per hour was modest, it flew higher than most fighters, ensuring survivability. The B-36 became the cornerstone of America's nuclear deterrent during the late 1940s and 1950s. It also handled reconnaissance and conventional bombing missions when required. A total of 384 B-36 were built, marking a key stage in strategic bomber evolution. The third U.S. strategic bomber is the Boeing B-50 Superfortress, which was introduced in 1948. She was developed shortly after the World War II as an improved version of the B-29, designed to meet the emerging Cold War demands. It featured four powerful Pratt & Whitney R-4360 radial engines and a stronger airframe for longer-range missions. With a maximum speed of around 394 miles per hour, and a combat range of 2,394 miles, it could carry substantial bomb loads over intercontinental distances. Its payload capacity reached up to 20,000 pounds, including conventional and nuclear weapons. A total of 370 units were built. The next strategic bomber that the U.S. built is the Boeing B-47 Stratojet. The B-47 Stratojet was developed as the first all-jet strategic bomber of the USAF, intended to penetrate Soviet airspace at high subsonic speeds. Introduced in 1951, it was designed with swept wings and six turbojet engines, giving it a top speed of 607 miles per hour and a combat range of approximately 2,013 miles. Its primary payload was up to 25,000 pounds of bombs, mainly nuclear, though it could carry conventional munitions as well. The B-47 revolutionized strategic bombing by combining speed, altitude, and jet power, which made it harder for interceptors to reach. Over 2,042 aircraft were built, serving as the mainstay of the Strategic Air Command in the 1950s. After the B-47, the next strategic bomber the U.S. built was the Boeing B-52 Stratofortress. The bomber was introduced in 1955 to provide long-range strategic bombing with nuclear and conventional payloads. Powered by eight turbojet, later turbofan engines, It could reach speeds of 650 miles per hour and fly unfueled for 8,800 miles, making it a true intercontinental bomber. Its massive payload capacity of 70,000 pounds allowed it to carry nuclear bombs, cruise missiles, and conventional ordnance. Over 744 were built, and the aircraft remains operational more than 65 years after its introduction. Its operational role has evolved from nuclear deterrence during the Cold War to conventional precision bombing in conflicts like Vietnam, Desert Storm, and Afghanistan. With modernization programs, B-52 is expected to remain in service past 2050, potentially reaching 100 years of operation. After the B-52, the next strategic bomber the US built was the Convair B-58 Hustler. The B-58 Hustler was introduced in 1960 as the first operational supersonic bomber for the USAF, designed to deliver nuclear weapons deep into Soviet territory. It featured a delta wing design powered by four J-79 turbojets, allowing it to reach Mach 2 and altitudes above 63,000 feet. Its primary armament consisted of a single nuclear bomb carried in a streamlined external pod, though conventional bombs could also be used. The B-58 emphasized speed and altitude over defensive armament, sacrificing crew survivability for penetration ability. Only 116 were built due to high costs and maintenance demands, but it demonstrated the feasibility of supersonic strategic bombing. After 26 years, the US introduced another strategic bomber, the Rockwell B-1 Lancer. This bomber was designed to combine long-range strategic bombing with low-level penetration capabilities, replacing high-altitude bombers threatened by Soviet air defenses. Its variable geometry wings and four of F-101 turbofan engines allowed supersonic speeds up to Mach 1.25 while maintaining combat range of 3,444 nautical miles. The B-1 can carry up to 50,000 pounds of nuclear or conventional ordnance, including cruise missiles and precision-guided bombs. Initially a nuclear bomber, it was converted to a conventional role after arms reduction treaties. Over 104 were built, and it remains a core part of U.S. long-range strike forces. Defensive systems include electronic countermeasures and terrain-following radar rather than heavy guns. It has seen extensive conventional use in conflicts like Iraq and Afghanistan, demonstrating precision strike capability. After a decade, the U.S. introduced another strategic bomber, the Northrop Grumman B-2 Spirit. This bomber was developed to penetrate dense, modern air defenses using stealth technology, enabling global nuclear and conventional strike missions. Its flying wing design and low radar cross-section reduced detectability. Four F-118 engines provide supersonic speeds for about 630 miles per hour with a range of 6,900 miles. It can carry up to 60,000 pounds of precision-guided bombs, cruise missiles, and nuclear weapons. Only 21 were built due to cost and complexity, but it remains highly effective in high-threat environments. Its stealth allows deep penetration without fighter escort, a major shift from early bombers. B-2 employs advanced avionics, electronic countermeasures, and all-weather capabilities. It has proven highly effective in conflicts such as Kosovo, Afghanistan, and Iraq. Its legacy continues as the bridge between traditional and next-generation bombers. The next strategic bomber the US built is the Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider. This is the next-generation US strategic bomber designed to replace aging B-1 and B-2 aircraft with stealth, range, and survivability in contested airspace. Developed under the Long Range Strike Bomber program, it is expected to enter service around 2027. While exact specifications remain classified, it is projected to carry approximately 20,000 pounds of thermonuclear or conventional ordnance. Its design emphasizes ultra-low radar cross-section, advanced avionics, and integration with drone assets. The Raider will operate intercontinentally, relying on stealth network systems rather than speed or altitude for defense. Three numbers have been built so far. The B-21 will set the standard for strategic bombing for the mid-21st century. Its development ensures U.S. global strike dominance well into the 2050s.